Good evening, welcome again to CDC and TV. I don't know where the year has gone. It's already at the end, we're already into December, and this is our final show for 2016. We're gonna welcome back a couple of guests that are with some organizations that do a lot in Ventura County. First, we're gonna welcome Eric Stenard, right?
Mm-hmm.
Did I say that right?
Sure.
And he's with Interface Children and Family Services. And a bit later, we're going to welcome back old friend Bonnie Atmore from Food Share Ventura County to talk about not only holiday needs for those in need, but also looking forward to 2017. And I'm pinch hitting for Joe Vaca, and Alexis Wallace is with us too. And just want to note, we've got the paintings from the Pleasant Valley Senior Center behind us. They got some great artists, so check that out. Welcome.
Thank you.
So Interface is like a big safety net for a lot of people, and they provide a lot of education, intervention. Could you give us a little overview of what Interface does?
Sure, happy to. So Interface is one of our community's most comprehensive social service safety nets, operating in our community across the region for 43 years.
Really?
Yeah, that's
wow.
Right. It's been a while, since the mid-70s.
Yeah.
And so we have pioneered a number of different programs in our region here, sheltering domestic violence victims, starting our state's first 211 information referral service, sheltering runaway and homeless youth, and most recently we've been working with human trafficking victims.
Really?
Helping them to get to safety and provide services to help them to resolve some of the traumas that they've gone through.
That's horrible.
Can you give us another example of maybe why someone would need to call on Interface?
Sure, yeah. Well, we help probably about 27,000 people a year.
Wow.
Through our various services. So sometimes it's a parent calling because they have a child who maybe had experienced some trauma and they're looking for some mental health services for their child. Or maybe it's an older person looking for services for a relative and who's calling 211 just trying to find out, well, what kinds of help is available in the community. Or it could be someone a safe plid here looking for